Welcome to Brownstown Raceway, everybody. Under new management this year, he's put a lot of work into it, put new bleachers in on the front stretch. So hopefully it turns out. We hope to be racing a lot here this year. Stay tuned, we'll see how tonight goes.
So an update on the radiator. This is our old radiator. We took the one we ran the last 2 weeks to Glenn. He hot tanked it and he found about 2 to 3 inches of gel in the bottom of it. We don't know what it was, where it came from, or how it got in there. But hopefully this one runs cooler. Car signed in tonight. We drew number 30. Be heat races only, 3 heats. How you finish is how you start. We will be in heat race number 2, starting second row inside. Hot laps will be coming up shortly.
Yeah, but what makes you, what, both of them?
Huh?
Both of them?
Well, the water's moving in the radiator.
Got the 230 in the heat race again. Got the 230 in the heat race again. Daryn went down and talked to Adam Tischhauser, who won, ran second in heat race number one. He said his was 230 as well, so. Don't know.
Maybe it's just a bad fucking sensor.
But it puked all, well, this is a different radiator, but it did puke half the water out last weekend.
Last week it puked all of that.
It was half
was
full. Yeah.
But different the radiator did not have a leak.
Did it?
Huh? What?
Did it have a leak?
No.
No. It was pressure tested.
Where the fuck is it going?
What were you saying?
Well, we'll find out.
So, years ago, and you guys didn't do any. You guys
all the blue gray cars. We bolted on the radiator, square tubing, where the rack bolts to now, we would bolt just a piece of skirting, and it would rub the racetrack and bring air up. Well, now our...
I mean, you shouldn't have to do it. I'm just looking for fucking...
Everything.
We've done it for 4 years.
Oh, I understand.
That don't make sense. We've been just done it for 4 fucking years.
Hell yeah.
I thought it was something easy to fucking slap on there, you know what I mean?
We are dead nuts on fuel. So, where are our carburetors set? I mean, literally, we're 600 feet and 1,500 feet is the position we're in. So, I mean, we're...
Did you?
Distributor, it's dead nuts on the line. Crank trigger, it's down about that far on the line.
We always gotta set a little higher.
Huh?
We always gotta set the crank a little higher.
No, it's advanced on the crank trigger.
We always do.
Not on the crank trigger. Crank trigger's reset, 31 degrees. Heavy run it on the distributor.
Still searching for answers.
Eight?
Well, that bar, it's on the bottom side. The bark's here and it's down here. So that's about 8 degrees.
I don't think I can hear anything. Hey, first off,
thank you,
man.
Thank you.
Hey.
Oh yeah.
How about a round of applause for Josh? This guy. Thanks, man. Thanks. It's fucking great. I love this place.
You're taking pictures?
Yeah.
Or video?
That's good.
Hey, draw me a name for 50-50.
There's cash in there.
Oh, I know. All right, maybe I'll get up here and it'll come in.
Good deal. Thanks, man. I appreciate it. Dad, over here.
You can feel it off your neck.
Oh.
Good job, man.
Thanks, man.
I got it.
So just before the feature, when we were checking the timing, we figured out what our heating issues were. The crank trigger timing is off by almost 8-9 degrees, which will cause the motor to get hot. So we went to the distributor for the timing, and we only got to 210 in the feature and ran 19 green flag laps. So I think we got that issue solved, but why the crank trigger is that much off from what it was a month ago, we don't know.